submit this message on PayPal that they need more information from you in order to allow you to access full functionality on PayPal. So in this video, guys, I'll show you guys exactly how to submit those documents, like upload a photo ID, confirm a card, provide a credit card statement, right? I'll show you guys how to submit all this and get your account fully back functional in this video. So without further ado, guys, let's dive right into it. Okay, welcome back, guys. I'm Chipdo Original. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this channel, I teach you guys how to make money online, how to invest your money and make your money work for you as well. So you might consider hitting that red subscribe button if you don't, turning on the bell notification beside it, so you'll be notified each time I drop awesome and great videos like this that's giving you guys information. So in today's topic, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make your account fully functional again once you receive this message from PayPal that they need some information from you, like your ID card or voter's card or driver's license, any government issued ID card, and you have to confirm a card or provide a credit card statement. I'll show you guys how to submit all this, but for now, the impact of this have limited me to pay using PayPal, to refund money to customers, to send money or payments, to receive money or payments, and to withdraw money from PayPal. So all these five things have been restricted from this account, and I'll show you guys how to resolve them. So first of all, upload a photo ID. Come here and click on resolve. Now they will prompt you to select the card that you want to use. They have a driver's license, they have a passport, they have a military ID, they have a national ID number. So whichever one that you have, you can use it for this verification. So right here, I'm going to use driver's license for the purpose of this story. Then after that, click on browse file, then select the file that you want to upload. My own is in documents, this is driver's front. I'll click on open. So this is already uploaded. So after that, just simply click on submit. From the dashboard, you can see upload the photo ID submitted. So that reviewing the document I just submitted. So the second step is to confirm a card. So click on resolve. I prefer using this method. Now I prefer to use this one, confirm a card, because it's much easier and simpler. How to get your card statement is to log in the app that you use to receive notifications from your card. Let's say you are living in Nigeria, like UBA app. Open it, you can see your card statement there. You can easily download it from there. Then the bank option is using your bank statement, but it must not be more than 6 months ago. So it has to be between the windows of 6 months. So if it's more than 6 months, they will accept it. But they're looking more into credit card statement than confirm a card. So you can easily confirm your card. So I prefer this method. So click on resolve, then click on submit. Click on browse files. Come to where the document is. As for me, it's on downloads. Then click on this. This is it here. Click on open. Then after that, click on submit. Guys, as you can see, I've submitted the two documents, the photo ID, and I've confirmed the card. So guys, make sure that the information you submit tallies with all the information you have on your account. You go to your account settings, you can make sure that all the information, for example this photo ID, the government issued ID card I submitted, I tallies with the information I have here on the PayPal settings. If I come here on settings and go to account settings, I'll make sure that my profile, like my name, tallies with the ID card I submitted, the date of birth tallies, and everything tallies. Here's the login information, here is the personal information. Here you can check if your name, everything tallies. 30 minutes, they will resolve the document you submitted and get back to you, so your account will be fully functional. Now, another thing that I want to say is that to get your account for them to request this, there must be a major changes in your account, like maybe you logged in using a different IP that they haven't seen before, or maybe you just added a new currency as your primary currency, you changed from maybe USD to GBP or something like that. As the case may be, this was a change in your account that is not usual, or maybe you received a foreign a huge amount of money, something like that. So they need this to verify your identity. just to go ahead. And once you are done with this verification, they won't request for it again. All right, guys, so I'll see you guys on my next video.